Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. In a previous video, we took a closer look at the iron that we can find in our food using some very strong magnets. Take a look at this. The iron in the spoon was attracted to these very strong magnets. Now, the iron in the spoon is all in one piece, but the iron we find in our food really is in really, really small bits that might look something like this. I have really tiny small bits of iron called iron filings, and we're gonna see if this is just as magnetic as our spoon is. So I just have one of those really strong magnets I'm going to put into a baggie because I'm thinking those iron filings are going to be attracted to this magnet, and I want to be able to get the magnet off of those iron filings, so I need the baggie. Now, let's see what happens when I have my really strong magnet. We're gonna zoom in so you can take a closer look and really watch what happens to these iron filings. So we have our really strong magnet in our plastic bag, and we have our iron filings. Let's see what happens. Pretty cool. I can drag the magnet around, and it looks like all of those iron filings have been attracted to my magnet. We've zoomed in even closer so you can see how the iron filings actually follow the lines of force or the lines of magnetism. They're curving because they're following that line of force. Pretty cool. If this really strong magnet is strong enough to pull up these iron, I wonder if we can use some really strong magnets to pull out the iron that's in our cereal. So we looked at the nutrition facts on our cereal, and we found that this cereal that we're using right now has 65% of the iron that our bodies need each day. We think that's enough iron that we can actually pull that out with a magnet. But to do that, we're going to need to crush this cereal, and that's the fun part. So we have our cereal in our bag, now it's time to mash it up. To do that, there's really nothing scientific. You could do this to music, you can karate chop it, you can pound it. You don't want to hurt yourself, but I want to break that cereal up into tiny, tiny bits. Now, the smaller we can break our cereal up, the better. So to speed things up, we're going to use this food processor. And now take a look. We're going to zoom in so you can see how nicely our cereal has been broken up. So you can see our cereal almost turned to a powder. We were able to break it up so small. And I wonder if I take my spoon, stick my spoon in, no cereal actually sticks to that spoon. But what happens if I take my magnet? Let's drop my magnet and take a look what happens. Small powdered bits of our cereal is actually sticking to our magnet. Well, what do you think is in the cereal that's attracted to our magnet? I think it's iron, and I think we can even try to pull that iron out and see if we can see the iron. So we have our bag of broken up cereal. Now we need to add the water, which will help us drag the iron filings to one little part of the bag. You want to be careful to not add too much, but you're going to see the cereal is going to absorb the water, and we want this kind of like runny oatmeal. Fill it up, and I'm going to massage the cereal with the water. So we've added our water and we have our cereal slush. And the most important thing is you want to make sure that your bag is totally sealed, because we're going to be turning this on its side and massaging it out. Looks like we need to get a little more air out so I can take my magnet and run it over our bag again and again and again and see if we can get our iron into one specific corner. So I have my really strong magnets and all my nice cereal in here. And now what I need to do is take my magnets and just slide it across the baggie nice and slowly to one spot. And I'm always coming back to that one spot because I'm dragging the iron in the cereal with my magnets and leaving it in this corner. Now I need to do this for a few minutes so that I can gather and collect all that iron. So we've zoomed in so we can see if we can find any iron filings in the corner of our bag, and look what we found right in the corner. It's dark colored iron that looks almost like the iron filings we poured out in the beginning of our video. Let's see if we can prove that this really is iron using our magnet. So we have the end of our really strong magnet. I'm going to get it close to our iron filings and see what happens. You can see they follow my magnet everywhere. I'm going to just play around with this to see if you can watch. You can see it's totally following my magnet. That's the iron we pulled out of the cereal using our magnet. So cool. So we have a collection of iron filings right here. Let's see if I can use the magnet to move them. So cool. Put them right back in the corner. This is a really cool thing that you can try at home. You just need some really strong magnets and some cereal. Now, we decided to go with a lighter colored cereal because it was a lot easier to see the iron in our cereal. This cereal actually has more iron in it, but because it was darker in color, it was harder to see. If you want to learn more about magnets and what our bodies need to stay strong, check out our links in the video description. Science is so cool, and it's everywhere, even in our breakfast cereal. Thanks for watching.